Clap. Okay. When you become a woman, what do you think is going to be your job?
To have kids, get a job, go grocery shopping.
Do you think that boys and girls should be treated the same?
I wanted to be a dancer early, but I also started designing clothes, making clothes when I was really young. And I think just being into fashion and the arts structured my thinking.
My parents would come home after school every day and say, "What did you learn?" And when I would talk about history or things we'd learn about current events, they would always give me more things to read or more things to consider to encourage me to deeply question. So I was very much encouraged to speak my mind. And if I saw a problem going on in the world, I was encouraged to be a part of the solution, to fix it, to change it, and to transform it. So my parents encouraged me to run for student government, to start the recycling club at school, to write for the student newspaper, to go to writing camp, which I did, and now I love to go back and read those writings that I did then. And they were always encouraging me to feel that my voice was valuable, that my ideas and my opinions were valuable, so much so that my mom even gave me my first book, which was a book that I created with her out of tape and staples and pen and paper when I was about 5 or 6 years old. And when I got this job, she gave me my book to remind me that I always knew that I had being a writer and an editor and a publisher and storyteller as a part of my destiny. I'm Jamia Wilson, and I am the executive director and publisher of the Feminist Press.
So you think that boys and girls should be treated equally? But why?
Because, it's not fair boys and girls get treated differently. Because, if a girl gets something that a boy wants but he can't have, it's not fair.
Well, why not?
Because, if somebody says, a girl could go to this school, a girl could go to school but the boy can't, it's not fair.
My name is Angela Dunn. I'm here today to strike for women everywhere. This is explicitly anti-capitalist, anti-racist, and inclusive feminism for the 99%. We are in Washington Square Park, New York City, March 8th, on the anniversary of International Women's Day.
What do you know about our president, Donald Trump?
He wants to keep the Mexicans out of America.
Do you think he respects women? Or you don't know?
I don't know.
If you become president, will a woman make the same as a man? And do I get to choose what I do with my body?
You're gonna make the same if you do as good a job. You're going to make the same if you do as good a job.
Do you believe in punishment for abortion? Yes or no, as a principle?
The answer is that there has to be some form of punishment.
For the woman?
Yeah, there has to be some form.
Well, obviously, it's great outer beauty. I mean, we could say politically correct that the look doesn't matter, but the look obviously matters. Like, you wouldn't have your job if you weren't beautiful.
I'm going to give you a hypothetical.
Go ahead.
Melania is in a horrible car accident. Her body is fine, except for the fact that her left arm is paralyzed now. It's useless. Okay. It hangs there like a slab of meat.
Right. How do the breasts look?
The breasts are okay.
Okay, well, that's important.
So Donald Trump says a lot of not nice things about women. And he usually thinks that he's better than women and that he can not do whatever he wants, but he does a lot of things that aren't okay in regards to women. And do you think that's okay that the president should be treating women less equal than men?
No.
What concerned me was that when you look at who voted for him, a good majority of white women voted for him. As opposed to black women voting 90% for the other candidate, and as well as black men. But for some reason, when it came to white women, it was like a large portion of them voted still for Trump. It went against what would benefit them in terms of their equal rights. Other concern for me is reproductive rights. And I do believe that we as women should have the right to choose if and when, or to have children if we so choose to have children. And it shouldn't be something that's forced upon us and seen as something that we have to do because we're women. Just because I'm a woman doesn't mean I have to have a child. It should be a choice of mine. It shouldn't be imposed on me by society. It is my body.
Do you know what feminism is?
No.
So feminism is basically a woman's belief that she should be treated the same as a man.
I'm generally a feminist, but I would call myself more of a womanist. A womanist is as black women, I think we tend to use that because it's focusing on what we are and what we have the choice of becoming.
I am a woman. I benefit from that. But I can't also separate the fact that at the end of the day, when I go out for a job, I most likely will be hired over a black man. Knowing that, I would consider myself more of a womanist. If I would say anything, I don't like labels at all.
So do you consider yourself a feminist?
Yes, I am a feminist. I'm proudly a feminist. And I'm also a womanist. I get that question a lot. And I believe that feminism simply means that I believe in the social, economic, cultural, and political equality of people of all genders and all races and all classes. Feminism is about equality.
Do you think that you are a feminist?